This work, and the title of this work is all over the place. I think the title of this work is On Earth As It Is. On Earth As It Is. So the completion of that would be On Earth As It Is in Heaven. There are a couple of things happening. The foundation of the work is the thing that alarmed me probably the most that I saw at the on January 6th, which is the raising of this gigantic cross. And it took about 7 or 8 full-grown men, you know, to raise it. So, like, you can see them. That some of it's gotten lost, but I spent a lot of time actually designing. Here are 2 figures. They're holding a rope, and here's another figure in the middle. He looks like he's orchestrating it. Someone's lifting up here, and then there's a large cross that's being erected. What used to be here, which you can't see anymore, was the Capitol building somewhere in the middle. We've lost it. And then the other thing that was also visible here were gallows, which have since kind of like faded away with pencil. But the foundation of this work is the raising of the cross at the Capitol in the midst of all of these different kinds of flags, some that represent Christianity and others that really appear to be the antithesis of all things, of anything Christian. The image is now layered with this other image of 2 people who are surrounding a black figure that I believe is one of the angels of the benediction series. And he is looking out at us, or looking out somewhere, as communion elements are being kind of forced on him. There's the bread or the biscuit there, and this is the blood, right? The blood in a glass, right? And there's a noose nearby. I wanted the noose to be I wanted it to be there because of what we saw at the Capitol building. But that noose at the Capitol also reminded me of all the things we've learned about in American history. You know, so whether or not the noose was for Nancy Pelosi or whoever they say it was for, that image is a trigger point. So the fusion of the noose with the cross for me transported me back into history with this kind of image. But of course, in this case, the people who are about to execute, who are about to lynch this man, this angel, are wearing those broken, tattered Jesus face masks. And again, the project is titled In His Name, the full project. This idea that these actions, whether those at the Capitol or those, you know, 100 years prior, were somehow being done with the grace and with the covering and with the blessing of our blessed Lord Jesus Christ is astonishing to me. And what's even more astonishing is that it's not astonishing to a lot of other people, is that it feels normal. And so the image itself is, you know, I'm still playing around with it. I'm still messing with it. At the bottom of this work, this is where I'm beginning to see the structure of the Capitol itself being formed with angelic limbs, with their arms, with their heads. I have always seen, you know, like large spheres here that represent the heads of the benediction angels, the head, as if they were there on the Capitol scene. This would be the eye, the nose here. But it's as if they're standing on top of the angels as they're doing this, right? I can imagine this angel's arm being stretched out and holding the top of the image as if buttressing the Capitol space itself so that we can actually see the image unfold.